those who believe in me, even though they know I will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come.
Pray.
Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, Jesus, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that Laura and all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The response to Lord, hear us, is Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. We give thanks for the gift of Laura's life. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. We give thanks for the many, many ways that Laura touched and enriched the lives of everyone around her. For the generosity of her heart, her hospitality, her parties, laughter, fun, together with her constant caring and kindness towards others. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all the people gathered here, for Laura's family and friends, both here and overseas, that mourn as they join with us today. May they be comforted. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. The reading from the prophet Isaiah, which tells of the truth that in death even we are not to be feared. We are not to be fearful because the good Lord loves us and redeems us, redeems our lives and takes us to himself. So these words from the prophet Isaiah. Now the Lord says this, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Saviour. You are precious in my sight and honoured, and I love you. Do not fear, for I am with you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We sing now our second hymn, which is the well-known Psalm of Consolation, Psalm 23. Truth that God walks with us in life as in death. He walks with Laura as she makes her journey to be forever with him in his nearer presence. So we sing the Lord's My Shepherd.
sure that today Diana Clare and other members of the family are at this time very much with us in spirit as we remember, pray and give thanks for Laura at this service. There is so much to her life, I know, that we shall shortly be remembering. So much indeed to be thankful for. So much to give thanks to God for in all those relationships, in all those many ways in which Laura has reached out and touched the lives of both, yes, her family and her friends too. And again here, as well as thanking you all on behalf of Diana and her family, a thank you as well on behalf of Laura's friend and carer Audrey for all the help, cares and support she has received in caring for Laura. And I know Audrey would not mind me saying this, but she counted her like a second mother, a very close relationship there too. So lots of love in this service surrounding us, the love of God, the love that we have for Laura, the love that we share as families and friends together. All of it, of course, that deep meaning and special love, a reflection of God's eternal, everlasting love that takes us through death into life with Him. And so we continue with our service with a reading from St. Paul's letter to Timothy, which seems very appropriate for Laura, for a long life. God granted her the grace of a very long life, a life with many twists and turns, with all sorts of people along the way. And now that her life's journey has come to its close, she is now given to God, who takes her to Himself to be with Him forever till that day we are all of us reunited before Him. So from St. Paul's letter to Timothy. The time has come for me to be gone. I have fought the good fight to the end. I have run the race to the finish. I have kept the faith. All there is to come is the crown of righteousness reserved for me, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me. The Lord will bring me home safely to His heavenly kingdom. To Him be glory and praise forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And another different reading, this time a poem. Poem by the great Christian writer Christina Rossetti, which has the simple title of Remember, but which is filled with profound thoughts of what it means to remember. Remember me when I am gone away, gone far away into the silent land, when you can no more hold me by the hand. Nor I half turn to go, yet turn and stay. Remember me when no more day by day you tell me of our future that you planned. Only remember me, you understand. It will be late to counsel then or pray. Yet if you should forget me for a while and afterwards remember, do not grieve. For if the darkness and corruption be a vestige of the thoughts that once I had, better by far you should forget and smile than that you should remember and be sad. There's a note at the end of that poem as we can read, which says, for Laura indeed wrote of herself, I would like to be remembered for my caring, my help, and my understanding of other people. I would be honoured to be remembered with love, not grief. So on that note, I ask Jane to come forward on behalf of
Clare's eulogy to her beloved mum, Laura. My dearest beloved mum, I thank you for giving me the gift of life. Never in my darkest moments could I have ever imagined or believed that I would not have been there to comfort and to hold your hand throughout the past few weeks, and indeed to not be physically present there with you today. I am right there with you in spirit, Mum, offering my love to you and my utmost thanks to everyone gathered here today in celebration of you. My lasting memories of Mum are simple. She had her own moral compass, firm yet kind. She was a force of loving kindness in this world. Mum valued honesty and was a hard-working, passionate figure of strength who never waned in her support and love for me whilst I was growing up, and who soldiered on even when times were tough. One of her familiar phrases being, "Press on regardless." As a daughter, I always saw you as inclusive of your own mother, Clara, for every Sunday without fail, Nana would share the day with us. You cared for her medical well-being, and for her every need until the day of her passing. I know that you did love your mum so very much and felt great sadness in your lifetime at the early loss of your father, Llewellyn, who was your trusted close companion as you were growing up and whom you loved dearly. May you all be united together once again in heaven. Mum, I have very fond memories of you, taking me together with my friends on afternoon picnics to Lady Bower in particular, such a pretty spot. On another note, I do so recall your passion for stiletto-heeled shoes, and I vividly remember standing beside you as you would apply your makeup, style your beautiful glossy hair, and then strut those heels. How I longed for the day when I would officially be a grown-up and could do the same. In my younger years, you accomplished such a great deal, Mum, particularly by selflessly raising funds within the community, by being a very active committee member for Cancer Relief and the Lifeboat Society, to name but two charities. You led by example, Mum. You were my greatest teacher from an early age. And to quote Sir Winston Churchill, "We make a living by what we get. We make a life by what we give." Mum, you were amazing in the eyes of my teenage friends, considered fair, tolerant, and understanding of modern day times. You were such a good sport. Countless of the times in the late 60s when you would drive us to Sheffield to Stringfellows Club, only to return at 2 a.m. to safely pick us up so that the other parents involved would allow their daughters to go too. In our eyes, you were the best. So how does one define best? Well, in my case, through your unwavering commitment to long hours of sheer hard work and a great deal of selfless sacrifice. There were times when you would be working two jobs, Mum, to enable me the privilege of attending boarding school and later college. It was through your determination and foresight to seek out the best schooling and education for me that I then went on to study and fulfil a career as a high school teacher. For this profound opportunity in life, and so much more, I thank you today, Mum, from the bottom of my heart. When in doubt, you were there to give me the assurance, "Of course you can do it, that's my girl." Words I shall never remember, I shall always remember, for your girl did go on to achieve many things. At the age of 23, my career as a high school teacher served me well, not only through the early years of my marriage, but also upon a newfound life in Australia, where together with Philip, you were gifted two beautiful grandchildren, Robert and Caroline. You always had a youthful spirit, Mum, and shared such a fun-loving relationship with your grandchildren whenever you would come to stay with us in Sydney. In the latter years, it is us that have travelled to see you. It is we, your family and friends, that honour you today as too special to ever forget. We will hold you in our hearts forever. God bless Mum, your loving daughter, Diana.
Jesus said to his friends, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too." The Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the hymn now, which is the hymn, "Abide with Me."
Thank you.
As I suggested earlier, this service is shot through with love. Love for Laura. And that love is expressed in all the many sentiments that are echoed by those who know and who love her and who remember her today. And so we have another two tributes from family members, beginning with one from Robert Haig. And this is what Robert says, and I read this on his behalf. I'm deeply saddened by the loss of my Nana Laura, but take this opportunity to share with you my sincere love and admiration of her. I know you had so many good friends and you really knew how to enjoy life. Some of those friends you will be with now in God's kingdom, heaven. I feel sure they will be rejoicing to be in your company once again. I often think how lucky I am and was to have an Anna like you, and will hold your love of friends and family close to my heart. I have very fond memories of you, Nana Laura, when you would visit us in Australia whilst I was growing up as a young boy. Most summers we would be in southern Queensland in Noosa or Surfers Paradise. These were really fun holidays and times I will remember for the rest of my life. One of the things I loved about you, Nana, was you always found time to share with me. We would be up at 5:30 in the morning to go fishing together down on the jetty in the Noosa River. I remember we carried a bucket home most mornings with fish I wanted to keep as pets for as long as I could. We had some great times on the Noosa River with Terry and Joanne, the managers of the hotel we stayed at, enjoying days on their boats, water skiing, and on team boats exploring the river with huge buffets of food and drinks. Heading out with you, Nana, was always good fun, and I always knew whenever you were with us, we were always going to have a lot of fun and a good laugh. You were always so witty and quick with your jokes, making me laugh a lot. That's another thing I loved so much about you, Nana. I always felt very loved by you, and felt I could tell you anything. You would listen and make light of things if there was something bothering you, helping me to be positive, and always bringing out the best in me. I have very fond memories of visiting you in the UK now. You made me delicious cooked bacon and egg breakfasts with yummy mushrooms. Your house was full of beautiful ornaments and antiques, many things you collected over the years. I know this was a passion of yours, collecting treasures at markets and antique shops. I enjoyed listening to your stories of where your treasures had come from and why you loved them so much. In the later years, we did not get to share so much time together, but I found great comfort knowing that you were greatly cared for and kept safe with Audrey's care. I want to thank you, Audrey, for myself and family, for the friendship and loving care that you always gave to my Nana. So any road up, Nana, I know you love that saying. You had a precious place in my heart and will forever. May you rest in peace, knowing you will never be forgotten, and we will meet again one day. I love you, Rob. And then this further tribute from Philip in Australia. Laura Bretherick became my mother-in-law on the 3rd of August, 1972. I had known her for around 6 years before that time. Shortly after my wedding day, I was faced with a very difficult question to ask both Laura and my father-in-law, Gordon. Would they give their support to their only daughter, Diana Clare, joining me in migrating to Australia? Australia to start a new life. They both readily agreed. I think they trusted me and trusted both our vision for a better and more rewarding life. Imagine that question being put to every one of us today who have children. Laura was a smart, well-educated lady. In the early days, she worked very hard doing three jobs to enable her daughter Diana Clare to attend private boarding school in Fife, Yorkshire. She wanted her daughter to get a good start in life with a good, wholesome education and vision for the good qualities in life. She succeeded. I remember Laura having heaps of energy in those early days, floating from one social event on the calendar to another. She was an effervescent person with friends in many parts of the country. One day she would be invited as a guest to the Houses of Parliament. The next day she would be staying with friends on a houseboat on the River Thames in London. The following day she would be back working in a doctor's surgery. Many friends Laura attracted into her life were well-educated, humorous people with big characters. Dr. John Young, a good friend of Laura's, loved visiting from the south of England. He was one of the funniest men I had ever met. When you arrived at the home, you would play a trumpet that was hanging from the low ceilings in Laura's quaint cottage on the edge of Woolley Village. Her cottage was full of antiques that she had collected at the markets, private homes, and antique fairs throughout the country. I remember once being at a lovely evening venue in North Yorkshire for dinner and later dancing with our younger friends. To our surprise, Laura was there with a table full of her own friends. At one stage, Laura got up to dance with what appeared to be 6-inch-high heel shoes. However, from a distance, there appeared to be no heel visible. She looked amazing. She knew it. Everybody was watching as she danced. She loved the attention. Obviously, there had to be a heel, and on closer observation, you could just see it was an invisible perspex heel. Only Laura could get away with this, and she looked brilliant. She was a real entertainer. She was the life and soul of every party or family gathering. Always late, but never forgotten at all the social occasions she attended, she left her mark wherever she went. She could tell jokes all night, clean ones too, not even a swear word, such was her brain for recollection. Laura was exceptionally good with both our children, Robert and Caroline. She had enormous patience and always supported them, even when they were in obvious trouble with Mum or Dad. She regularly visited us in Australia, spending many fantastic holidays in Noosa and Surfers Paradise in Queensland. We had so many fun times together as a family. I visited Laura about 3 years ago. I said my goodbye, hoping it wasn't my final goodbye. However, I fear it might be. People with personalities and presence as big as Laura's are rare. I learned a lot from them. I will miss her. So after hearing those truths and recollections of Laura's life and all those ways in which she is counted as both special and unique, that is what she was, indeed is, in God's sight, and in yours, special and unique. As we remember those thoughts today, you will each of you have your own particular and special ways of remembering Laura, ways in which she has touched your lives, as well as the lives of family and close friends. So, I just want us to pause just for a moment, using the silence together as a time of recollection for all of us gathered here as we prepare. So with our thoughts, with our prayers, with the love that unites us to Laura, her to us, we offer the prayer that our beloved Saviour himself taught us, as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Congregation, please stand for the commendation. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory, claiming his promises, we entrust Laura to your mercy. In the name of Jesus our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you, now and forever. Amen. And may the love of God and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ bless and console you and gently wipe every tear from your eyes. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In peace, let us take our beloved Lord to commit her to God's eternal love and glory.